So hi Sanil, thank you so much for joining us today. Congratulations on scoring 99.62 percentile in CAT 2020.
Thanks a lot.
So can you tell us about your preparation journey, when you started preparing and all that?
Sure. So I started preparing in early January.
Okay.
I had been contemplating appearing for CAT since my third year started, but I hadn't been sure about it. So I took some time, talked to a few people, and finally got to this decision. From Jan onwards, I didn't really take any resources or any coaching. I just tried to prepare on my own from freely available resources. And that's when I actually came across CrackU, because CrackU had some portion of the syllabus covered.
Okay.
It was open freely for everyone, which is why I thought that CrackU would be a good website, a good platform for me to actually learn and get a good score. So I think I joined CrackU around June, and that's when my preparation actually kickstarted, because everything was given in such an organized manner. And plus, it made it really easy for you, because you didn't really have to think what to do. You just had to just study, and that's it. You know, this really helped me in my preparation personally.
Right. So since you're in the final year of your college, so how did you manage your preparation? Like, how many hours a day you allotted?
So to be honest, I got lucky that way, because with the whole lockdown happening, there were no classes March onwards.
Okay.
But before that, I think you just have to organize, and you have to understand the amount of time required for CAT and college preparation. So personally, during that period when I actually had college, I was devoting roughly 3 to 4 hours preparation to CAT. Because initial stages, it's just about knowing all the concepts, having strong fundamentals. And I was spending close to 1.5 hours to 2 hours on just my college projects, exams, so on and so forth.
Great. So how did you stay motivated during this journey?
Okay, so I think people need to realize the fact that it's not a marathon. It's actually a marathon, not a sprint. So you have to pace yourself. There will be times when you're not getting good scores. For me, this happened around, I would say, August, September. And the exam was in November. So obviously, I got tensed up since the exam was barely a month away. But you need to realize that it's going to happen. There will be a time where you don't get good scores. And at the time, you just have to remain calm and trust yourself.
Right.
For me, personally, there was this really good show. It's called The Last Dance on Netflix.
Okay.
It's basically a documentary on Michael Jordan. And that show really spoke to me, because what they basically said about his mentality was that he never thought that he could possibly fail. That it never entered his mind, you know. And that sort of, I was impressed by that. And I kind of agreed with it. Don't forget about the result. Forget about you. If you think you will fail, there's no chance you'll ever succeed. So it's important that you don't focus on that. Focus on your task, focus on your goal, and that's it.
Yeah. Great. So can you tell us how many mocks did you give and how many hours you spend on analyzing each mock?
Okay. So I think I've given around 25 mocks.
Okay.
And I used to analyze each of them for at least, I would say, 2.5 to 3 hours minimum.
Okay.
And I would spend extra time on those mocks where obviously my scores were when I didn't perform so well.
Okay, so can you tell us what are some big mistakes you did during your preparation and how did you learn from them?
Okay, I think the biggest mistake one makes while preparing for CAT is just to be in a hurry to solve questions.
Okay.
Because you keep on hearing that there'll be X number of questions in Y amount of time. You have to have a very high accuracy and good speed as well. So because of which you stop focusing on the core concepts. And then you also have these supposed educational videos online which mention all these shortcuts and other methods for solving papers, which isn't true. CAT it's not rocket science. It's a simple paper. You have to have good fundamentals. And secondly, this is a very important point, you have to remain calm while preparing and while giving the paper on the exam. Because no amount of preparation can ever be a substitute for just being calm and composed. Sometimes that's all you need. So I think that's a very important point.
Great. So can you tell us about the strategy you followed in each section?
Okay. I'm going to start with VARC.
Okay.
So I cannot stress on this enough, but you need to have a reading habit. If anyone is trying to prepare for CAT, they need to start reading books. And it could be from any topic or any genre. Horror, comedy, biographies, whatever. But just read, because VRC, the section, they're not testing your speaking skills.
Right.
They're testing your comprehension skills. Whether you're able to understand the underlying message or the hidden points in a particular para, right? And that only comes if you've read a lot.
Right.
So that's one thing. In my case, I've been reading since a very young age. So VRC was always a strong point for me personally. Secondly, what I would suggest is that Crackio had these topic-wise videos.
Right.
So if you have weaknesses in particular topics, you can just go, and it's been explained really well. So it helped me. For example, I remember when you had certain difficult RCs, and you have really close options.
Right.
So how to differentiate between those two questions, between those two options, that's actually explained in those videos. They're really helpful. The next section is obviously DILR. Now, for me, this was the challenge because my scores weren't good enough. At one point, I remember scoring in 70s and 60s.
Okay.
So now, for me, what I realized was after analyzing my mocks that I had weaknesses in certain topics. For example, I had a weakness in Venn diagrams.
Okay.
The four set. So what you need to do, if you have an issue in DILR, is to just understand which particular type of question you're having an issue in, because it's not a question, there are actually sets of questions. So there'll be, based on the old pattern, 8 sets in a paper. Or the pattern which I got this year, we had 5 sets or 6 sets approximately. So each set has a type. It could be a Venn diagram, it could be a bar graph, it could be an arrangement question. So you have to identify which topic is your weakness and start solving sets of that particular topic.
Right.
The more you solve, the more time you give it, it's going to be sorted. And this is where I feel that Crackio did really well, because they actually had topic-wise preparation for each topic in LRDI or DLR, which wasn't there in other websites.
Right.
Secondly, for the last section is quant. So for quant, simple practice comes in, and there is honestly no substitute for practice in quant. You just have to go through every topic, understand the fundamentals, and then start solving questions. The more you solve, the better it's going to get. And one last thing, you can give as many topic tests, sectional tests as possible, but it's important to be regular with your mocks. At least give them, I don't know what the pattern will be for this year, but I remember we had a 2-hour mock instead of a 3-hour mock. So at least give one mock a week or two mocks a week, because it's just important to be very regular, you know. And I really like going forward. It relieves all the pressure from you, and you kind of get so used to the pattern that you're very relaxed on the final day of the paper.
Great. So can you tell us, how was it on the CAT day? Did it go as per your strategy? What surprises did CAT throw?
Honestly, whatever strategy you have for the day of the exam, that never works out. It always goes the other way around. Trust me, because every year, so you have the sample papers for the last 5 years, and the pattern is never repeated ever. In my case, I was slot 3 essentially, and apparently we arguably had the most difficult paper in the last 2 to 3 years. So our VRC section was somewhere from moderate to difficult, which was manageable. But the DILR section, which I just told you was my weakness, was the most difficult section which had come in the last 3 or 4 years. And as a result, many of my friends actually messed up their quant sections because they were so bogged down by what happened in the DILR section. So I think this is where I did well, because I realized that look, this has never been my strength. So whatever happens in this section, it happens. I won't actually let it affect my performance in quant. And like I just mentioned, I'd given 20 odd mocks. So I had a fair idea that there had been times where I didn't perform well in the DRR section, but I had gotten overall good marks because I'd kept my focus and did well in quant. So this kind of helped me. And again, I go back to my first point where I said that it's very important to remain calm,
Right.
because every year there'll be one section which will be difficult. So you can't get nervous or scared. It's just a paper. Even if you can't do that section, I know it's hard. I've given the paper myself, but you have to ignore that and move on. That's very important,
Right.
because otherwise you won't crack the exam. Honestly, that's very important. Just being calm and composed while giving the paper.
Great. So, can you tell us what was the one most important thing that actually helped you improve your scores in any section?
I think the most important thing which helped me improve my scores was, again, I'll go back to the DILR section. I was struggling miserably in there. I remember that sometimes it just used to be that I wasn't able to understand that particular set,
Okay.
because I used to be in a hurry to solve as many sets as possible. What I eventually realized during the course of my preparation was that you can't solve every question in that particular section. You can solve at best two or three sets. So it's about devoting the right amount of time to those two or three sets, which is where set selection comes into place. You have to select the right set. Secondly, when you have chosen a set, try and attempt it with a calm mind. Thirdly, and this happens a lot, if you cannot attempt that particular set, leave it. If I have 3 minutes, 4 minutes, whatever time you've wasted, it's fine. Cut your losses then and there. And fourthly, again, practicing the various types of sets which have usually come in DILR section. And this is where Kraku was a huge help, because they had segmented the entire preparation material for DIL into different topics, which really helped me personally.
Brilliant. So finally, is there anything else that you want to tell the CAT aspirants?
I think, okay, so firstly, there are a number of videos online,
Yes.
which is honestly just crap, because they don't know anything and they're spreading rumors essentially. Which have no basis. So ignore those. Secondly, as a gem fresher, you hear people say that it's almost impossible to get a call from any good IIMs. They show all these really massive cutoffs, which you feel is impossible to achieve. So you cannot really, at the time of your preparation, right, you shouldn't focus on that. Because if you do, you will miss the main goal, which is actually getting a good percentile in CAT. We're just thinking about scoring a 99.9 or 99.95 or whatever. Just stay focused, drown out all the noise, and work towards your goal. Lastly, and again, I'm stressing upon this, but you have to remain calm while
Right.
you're giving your and on the exam day. I personally know students who've actually done well in the CAT exam this year just because they were calm. And I also know some of my very close friends who didn't do well despite preparing equally as well as I had, simply because they got so bogged down by the DILR section that they messed up the quant sections. You have to remain calm and composed. And CAT isn't a difficult paper. Again, it's not JEE Advanced. It's a very simple, straight paper. Of course, there are a few hurdles in the paper, but it's achievable. So just be calm and you'll do well for sure.
Perfect. So thank you so much, Sanil. Thanks for your time and thank you for joining us today.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you.